Well, this is a an investigation into an underloved and perhaps underappreciated group of great artists called stand-up comedians. And we wanted to go out and find out who these people really are. When we first started talking about making this film, people would say to us things like, they're all manic depressives. Well, they're not. They're a very diverse and fascinating group of truth talkers. And we've learned lots of wonderful life lessons, but essentially they are the great students of the human condition.
We decided quite early on that we needed to make this different, and so we didn't want to have pithy remark and then cut to a bit of stand-up, particularly as it would be archive stand-up and it would be fuzzy old shots of comedians standing in front of a brick wall. We decided we wanted to talk about them and what they do and to not see stand-up, and so then we decided to shoot them in black and white to remove and against a raw canvas backdrop with the same setup and the same camera position for all of them, apart from Jerry Lewis, who changed everything, but so that there was an equality. So whether you've got Kevin Hart or you've got a comedian who's just starting out, who's maybe 19, 20 years old, they can talk about the same things, they can discuss the same emotions and process of going through this what stand-ups have to do to get their art going, as with that 70-year gap. And so that's what the point of that was, so that you focused on their words and not just thought, when am I going to get to the joke?
One of the fascinating things, I don't know if this is a straight answer, but when you go out on the road, as we have done with some very successful stand-up comedians recently as part of our spin-off TV series we're making on the same subject, we were with Sebastian Maniscalco in Florida the other afternoon, and you're very struck by the fact that there's one man in a car with an arena full of people waiting to listen to him, and he doesn't have any musicians with him or any backing singers or any dancing girls, and he walks out on stage without any props and he starts talking. And this may be one of the reasons why people don't lavish this with the praise it deserves, because it looks easy. There's a recent poll conducted in America where the question was, what are you most scared of? And number one was talking in public, and number two was dying.
There are some amazing comedians that have definitely changed bits of the world and changed the way we think about race and gender and those kind of things, because they're the subjects, when they get onto that stuff, they can really make a point Richard Pryor, George Carlin, Louis C.K.'s, you know, those kind of people, Chris Rock's, those, you know, Eddie Murphy's,
Seinfeld,
Jerry Seinfeld.
Eddie Murphy, all amazing.
And, but, you know, from someone you've never heard of can make the most salient point about that moment, about the world, in a tiny stand-up club in front of 20 people, and for those 20 people, they will get something that
will never... It may change their lives.
Yeah, I'm going to say that.